Hello, it's Jang here with a look at the alternate, well, the official alternate build for the LEGO Technic 2015 race truck. They call this one the race car for fairly obvious reasons. We already had the stickers placed on everything from building the race truck, and you can see the review that I did on that separately. The end result here, I think, is a great transformation of the original truck, because it looks nothing like the original truck. It doesn't look like it's made from pieces of the original truck, except for just the obviousness of those existing stickers that are there. Beyond that, I think that this is a good, solid, complete redo, and it looks good as a model on its own. This could have been sold just like this. Yeah, Technic does a lot of cars, but hey, I like cars. And this is a pretty good looking car. I don't know what kind of class it's supposed to be following. Kind of looks like some kind of modified stock car of some sort, you know, some small oval kind of car in its overall design. But then what's going on here with the intake? I'm not quite sure if that's supposed to be just some very large intake, or if that's supposed to be some kind of supercharger manifold. I don't know. You still get this great V8 engine in there. That's really important. I really like Technic engines. I say that all the time, and I won't stop saying it because I still am impressed by them. And you can see the cylinders or the pistons are able to go up and down, so it's still hooked up. You know, it's still connected to the rear tires on this one. And you do still have steering, which is pretty much mandatory for something of this size. Steering is from this knob back here at the rear of the roof. And it's in a good position for play for kids that want to just drive this thing around, because it's a good place from which to push the car, and then you can just control it as it goes along. I think this one is not quite as durable of a build as the truck version. There's some small things that can be relatively easily tweaked, but it's still not too bad. Doors, of course, full opening doors, much larger than on the truck version. This feels a little more solid in its construction compared to the original build. Everything is compacted down. It's flatter, and more things are in a smaller space. Interestingly enough, they give you a trunk on this one. You can open the deck lid up. There's no space. I mean, there's plenty of space, but there's no, you know, flat area to really hold anything, as there shouldn't be, because it's a race vehicle. Still have your differential there. Let's take a look at this from the underside, so you can see how things are hooked up. You got the two stacked stacked shafts. So one shaft for controlling the motor, the engine, getting that to run in the front, and then the higher shaft is just to connect to your rack and pinion setup in the front. What's most striking to me about this is how much open space there is on the inside. That's really, really useful, because this looks like it's almost designed to be hooked up with power functions. Make this into a full RC car with official power functions. It shouldn't be difficult at all. As a matter of fact, by the time this video is done, there are probably a bunch of folks who have already done this. I haven't looked, but I am curious to try it myself. I will not commit to doing that anytime soon, because I've got a lot of other stuff that's way higher priority, but I am curious. And I do want to keep this thing together to give that an attempt at some point when I do have the time. It has a little bit of kind of a faux suspension action back here, just because there's some flexibility to the frame, so that's actually good for traction if you do get this thing hooked up with power functions. I think it's a good looking thing. I think it would look a lot better without so many stickers on it. That's just my personal opinion, but it's a good build. It's a great transformation from the original form. It's still got the important elements that actually work in it, and like I said, looks like a great candidate for hooking it up with some electricity, man. So that does it for my thoughts on this one and my look at this one. If you have any thoughts that you would like to share about this model, please share your opinions down in the comment section. Also, if you'd be so kind, leave a little note saying which version of this set build you prefer. If you prefer the box art model of the race truck, or if you actually like this car better, that'll be interesting to see which is preferred out there. Hope you enjoyed this look at this build, and I hope that you'll stick around to check out more of my videos, because more are on the way very soon. Catch you later.